cheeky.
So the retailers are desperate for those products that cause people to make purchases today. Any category you can think of, as I said, cars. Have you heard of the Tesla car? That's down in the South Bay, San Francisco area. They've come up with an electric car. And it's 0 to 60 in 4.6 seconds or something. And this isn't without GM being bailed out. I mean, GM wants to be bailed out so they can do that kind of thing. But there are some people down in San Jose, they've done it without you know, government money and all that kind of thing. So I understand they're using their computer people and they're using laptop battery technology to power the car. So there's plenty to do. Certainly, there's plenty to do out there in the economy right now, and there is plenty of demand if you get the right products to present into that market. And you're in the same standing as the people out there that are established suppliers. They're scrambling to see what to sell next. So you're starting out. You're on the same basis as them. Some of your competitors out there that would be your competitors in whatever business you're going into, they're finding that they either took on too much debt during the boom times and they cannot service that debt, so they're in trouble. Now they're tied up. There's some of your competitors tied up. There's some that are doing perfectly well, perfectly fine businesses, except their bankers have withdrawn their lines of credit. Now what do? They can't function quite well. Then that goes backwards to the suppliers overseas who find themselves with fewer customers to serve. Exports are dropping from overseas, imports are dropping into the United States, exports to the United States are dropping too. Big drops. We're all the way back to 2006 levels. That's not very big of a drop going back just to 2006, but that was actually kind of boom time. So I'm sure it's going to drop more. I'm sure we're going to see more of this. But all that says is this is going to continue more. The suppliers more and more are going to get into trouble, so they're going to have trouble. The people who demand are going to have a harder and harder time getting the supply they need, and the people and the demand will continue to drop. But this part of the equation is dropping faster, meaning the opportunities are actually widening. Established businesses are finding challenges right now, of course. You starting out don't have any of those challenges. You've got the pure opportunity to go in and find out what the demand is, what the customers want, and then just put that deal together, unencumbered by all the other problems that establishes businesses if they haven't wisely managed the boom times, managed the businesses in the boom times. If they haven't done it, they're going to be struggling. Now, extremely few people manage their businesses well during the boom times. Extremely few people were able to see what's going on and keep calm and don't extend too far. That's not just business, that's homeowners, that's everybody, everywhere, governments, schools, everybody made that mistake, so everybody's in that jam. Question is, how do you get out of that jam? So they're going to work on that. And while they're working on that, they also have to find out what people are buying today. And that's exactly your job starting out, is what are people buying today? And that, of course, book, the seminars, that's what I cover. So this is just an update. Only thing I'm saying is, there's actually more opportunity right now because your competitors have been thrown for a loop, a lot of them. The suppliers are desperate, and the retailers especially are watching people walk into their stores, look around, and leave. Now, there's fewer people coming in, but those fewer coming in are looking around. They got money in their pockets. They wouldn't be in the stores if they didn't have money in their pockets to buy. But they're looking around and saying, nothing here to buy. There's no compelling products on the shelves. That's what they desperately need. That's why Hamaker Schlemmer is offering $2,500 to anybody that can come up with the products that they can sell inside their stores. So that's just an example of how desperate. You don't think the car dealers are screaming at the car makers, give us cars that people will buy? Well, small companies like Tesla down in San Jose, California, they're coming up with cars. They've got an actual waiting list for production cars. Now, they'll go to, I'm sure Tesla's going to go and get those cars faster and cheaper now, because they will go to actual car manufacturers, body manufacturers, and say, listen, we can give you the contract because we've got the customers. You're going to lower your prices for us, which is going to make that electric car cheaper, faster, better. But these things don't work too well. A bad sense of direction. And so they stumble round in threes. Such a strange collection. Oh, you headless chicken. Can those poor teeth take some?